Hi everyone, Dom Designs here, and in today's tutorial, I will teach you how to simply create an avocado in Adobe Illustrator. So today's video is perfect if you're a beginner at drawing in Illustrator. I will teach you how I draw with outlines and then add color and shadows on separate layers, just like I do on so many of my past illustrations. So let's dive into it right away. Let's create a new canvas at 1100 by 1100 pixels. As you can see, I have a few reference images of some avocados and my color palette with the color codes, which you can copy when following along. I'll begin by turning the reference sketch into a template. By the way, if you're new to the channel and you're interested in Adobe Illustrator process videos and tutorials, then please consider subscribing to the channel and hitting that bell icon so you don't miss an upload. I'll then be using a dark brown color for the stroke with rounded caps and corners. I will start by creating a circle by holding Shift on my keyboard on our outline layer. Next, I'll select the anchor point and move it upwards using the Direct Selection tool. Once we are done, let's create the side of the avocado by duplicating our shape by doing a copy and paste in back. Let's move over the shape to the right like so. Now, what I'll do is use the Direct Selection tool to delete this anchor point right here, and then with the Pen tool, I'll connect the top and the bottom of the new shape to create the backside of the avocado. Perfect, let's move on to creating the stem. Let's use the pen tool to create a straight line and make the stroke thicker. Then let's curve it using the curvature tool. Let's then vary the width of the stroke by using the Width tool. You can click and drag on different parts of the stroke to vary its thickness. We will then turn this stroke into a shape by going to the Object menu and selecting Outline Stroke. By clicking I on your keyboard, you will bring up the Eyedropper tool. So let's copy over the stroke to the stem. Now let's get rid of this overlapping shape right over here. I'll select everything and bring up the Shape Builder tool. And we can just click on the gray area right here to separate the shape. Let's move on to tracing the leaf with the Pen tool. And finally, let's complete the outline by drawing the pit inside the avocado. We're now done the outline, so let's start adding our base color. Firstly, I will create a new layer beneath the outline layer and name it Color. What we will do is select everything on the outline layer and copy it over to the color layer by holding down Option or Alt on our keyboard and dragging the little green square below to the color layer. I will then lock down the outline layer and reduce the stroke width of the illustration on the color layer. What we will do is turn our stroke into shapes by going to the Object menu at the top and Outline Stroke like so. Let's make sure to turn off the outline layer so we can see what we're doing. Then, I will head over to the Pathfinder panel to unite the new shapes that we created. What this did is create a compound path of the whole illustration. So let's right-click and ungroup, and then let's right-click again and select Release Compound Path, and then delete the outermost shape. This is perfect, so let's give everything a color and turn on the outline layer. Now all we have to do is select the shapes and use the Eyedropper tool to copy over the base colors to the avocado. To finalize, I will be adding some shadows and highlights. The light source will be coming in from the left side, so naturally the right side will have the shadows. I'll begin by adding the green ring around the inside of the avocado. Let's select the yellowish shape and do an offset path. This created a shape within our avocado, so let's just click on the outermost shape and give it a green color. Let's do the same for the pit. Next, what I'll do is create a round highlight on the left side of the pit. What I'll do now is show you how I easily add shadows. Let's select the shape of the pit and do a copy and paste in place twice. This will create three shapes superimposed on each other. I will then move the top shape to the left, creating a half moon gap. We want that gap to be our shadow shape, so we will select the top two shapes and bring up the Shape Builder tool. And holding down Option or Alt on your keyboard, let's delete the two shapes on the left side. We can then give the half moon shape a darker brown color for the shadow. Now that you know the main techniques, I'll just apply them to the rest of the illustration. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below and I'll try to answer them to the best of my abilities. Finally, I'll create a deep shadow by drawing a curved stroke. I will then make the center of the stroke thicker using the Width tool. And then I will outline the stroke to turn it into a shape and give it a dark green color for the deep shadow. And there you have it, everyone. This is how to create a simple flat design vector avocado in Adobe Illustrator. I hope you enjoyed the video, and please let me know your thoughts in the comments below. Cheers, everyone.